My goal for this gloss is to make it super sparkly and just really obnoxious. When I tell you I used 6 different sparkles for this lip gloss, believe me, because I really did. I want you to put this on your lips, and I want everyone to ask, what is on your lips? I need that. And I simply want you to say nothing, mind your business. And yes, I will be swatching this gloss on my lips soon.
So I've been following this brand on TikTok since their launch. It's a body care brand centered around quality and self-care. I love supporting women with small businesses. I bought all her samples to try and guys. The products are beautiful. You have to try.
This video is for all the little homies who want to learn how to resew. Here's a quick example on how to start for cheap. Here's step 1. Buy a pair of men's Jordans for under 30 bucks. And if you buy it for under 30 bucks, make sure you can sell it for double. So if you pay 25, make sure you can sell it for 50. If you pay 30, make sure you can sell it for 60. Finding the shoe is probably going to be the most difficult part. You could find the shoe on Facebook Marketplace, OfferUp, or even ask your friends if they have some shoes they want to get rid of. Step 2 would be put them up for sale. Put them up for sale on Facebook Marketplace, put them up for sale on OfferUp or Mercari. The key when you put it up for sale is make sure the listing looks nice, you take good pictures, and write a good description. Step 3 is make sure you can ship the shoes if it comes down to shipping. I suggest you learn how to ship just because not everybody who wants to buy the shoe lives next to you. Therefore, be willing and able to ship. This pair right here, I bought off a customer for 25 bucks. And today I sold it for 65. And after shipping, bro, I made about $36. And there's no reason why you couldn't do this too. It's very simple. Go ahead. And this is how you get to start in reselling.
I love selling shoes, but I hate this part. Zuki and I had a ton of orders to pack up, and this is by far my least favorite part of the process. We have to put all the boxes in order, open up all the boxes, then we have to inspect each shoe by hand. Quality is a big part of Kizzo. We would never send you guys shoes that we wouldn't wear ourselves, so we're sure to look every pair over thoroughly. We got a pretty good system going, so I would inspect the shoes, hand them to Zuki and David. They would put them in the box, throw a label on, and then we would stack up all the boxes. It filled a whole room. After all the shoes are in their boxes, we have to print out the shipping labels. This time, we didn't have UPS labels because we couldn't get them in time, so we had to use paper. It was a lot of extra work. We had to cut each individual piece of paper out by hand and then tape it with a lot of extra tape to the box. But we had to do this just because we didn't want everybody to wait. The last step is to load the truck up, obviously, and we even gave our UPS driver a free pair just because it was a lot of extra work. So that's it. This drop is done, and don't worry if you miss this one. The next one's October 15th.
Watch me take my orders to the post office. I love my customers so much. The employees always tell me I'm going to be so big one day. Thank you.
So this is beyond stressful. TikTok has once again shadow banned me. So that means not even 1% of my following is seeing anything that I post. I just had a restock today and I'm not getting any traction because I am shadow banned. So if you see this video, please leave a like, comment, share. Thank you.
If you don't know me, I'm Liv, and I just make a bunch of jewelry all day. Right now, I'm turning your names into necklaces, and I just decided to make a nose ring, and it ended up looking really nice. But usually, I make jewelry for good energy. These crystal necklaces are for confidence, and it helps with anxiety and stress. I have all these crystals for all different things, to help heal your soul, and to help you look like a goddess. But mostly, I do a lot of custom jewelry, and I love making the orders for you guys. I can't wait to make you a necklace next. Love you!
Cause I'm alright.
I started my resale business in 2017 with $40. I didn't have a lot of capital to start. I didn't make any excuses and kept grinding. Now, I have sneakers I only dreamt of having. Shop with me on IG at signer_etc. Don't sleep.
Why do I give out my recipes? I get this question so much, and my answer is because I know what it's like to have to check your bank account before you gas up, before you buy food, before you go to the dollar store and have to like purchase a few things just to make sure that you have enough and don't get publicly declined. If my recipes can help someone start a business to have a couple extra $100 a month, my life goal has been met. I don't do it so people can become millionaires. And yes, I'm aware that this can stop people from buying from me, but I do not care if this can help someone feed their 3 babies.
How much I make in a day as a lash tech? Client number one. Brown doll I set. $90 plus $20 tip. Client number two. Wispy cat I set. This set plus her eyes. $100 plus $5 tip plus $12 lash bath kit. Client number three. Another wispy cat I set. This set came out so bomb. $100. $327 day.
This person said Snoop Slimes has better quality slimes.
And I can agree with you on that. Yes, they do.
But they've also been doing their business for years, and they have, like, 3 million followers.
But don't get me wrong, I love Snoop Slimes. Like, I order from them every week, so I recommend.
But just so you know, every business has to start somewhere.
And we've almost had our business for a year, and I think it's improving a lot.
If you look at the slimes we first released to the one we're releasing this Saturday, get ready, I love these slimes. In a few years, we might be as good as Snoop Slimes. Get ready for a restock. Ask more.
One of the most annoying things about running a business, but more specifically a slime business, is the lack of acknowledgement for hard work and creativity just because the product isn't something many people deem to be mature. I don't know the person who commented this, and I can guarantee this person doesn't know me either, because they definitely don't see the hours spent testing recipes, researching manufacturers, coming up with prototypes, etc., just to make sure my slime is the highest quality it can be. In fact, I don't think anyone really sees that. People keep forgetting that it's really hard to document every single detail of one's life, and that there's so much more beyond what I decide to post on my TikTok page. So many people still fail to recognize the validity of my business just because I sell slime, and comments like these only further prove that. I get it's hard to understand, but if my slime is something you can make at home, go make it and leave me and my business alone.
I accidentally placed an order on All the Ring. Can you cancel it, please? Oh no, I just shipped it today. Let me know once it arrives. I just received the rings. Okay, let's start the return process. Actually, my friend really liked them. I was planning to buy them for my bridesmaids, but I was scared of small businesses in TikTok. I was thinking they are scams. So I won't be returning anymore.
There's no need for that.
Let's pack a $400 order for Angel.
Firstly, she got one of every single incense. And then she got pretty much one or two of every raw stone.
She got 3 flower agate dinosaurs. She got two fleshy labradorite spheres, a Larima mini heart carving, two rose quartz mushrooms, two moss agate mushrooms, and three flower agate mushrooms. Got a pair of black tourmaline and a pair of selenite earrings, and one of every tumble. She got an amethyst ring, which is size 7, and two hematite rings. She then got two small rainbow moonstone towers and two large rainbow moonstone towers, an aquitine calcite, also known as blue onyx, so beautiful, a sunstone tower, two beautiful strawberry quartz, which is also known as red aventurine, and one lapidolite tower. Choose this one. She got a large sunstone sphere. These are so flashy. A large lapidolite and pink tourmaline sphere, and a rainbow moonstone sphere. A large rainbow moonstone palm stone. This one's amazing. Oh my gosh. Two crackled quartz spheres. So many rainbows, I'm obsessed with these. A rainbow fluorite, let's pick the green one on the top. This has lovely rainbow in it. A large carnelian sphere, look at this one. It's like an eye. And two small carnelian spheres. The banding on this one's really lovely. She got three fluorite slabs, let's do four. Just because one of them's a bit smaller. And a medium-sized green apophyllite.
I'm running out of time, but she basically got one of every single bracelet.